Howdy folks, welcome back to SnowRunner. We are picking up where we left off in Northport, Alaska. Let's see what kind of trouble we can get into. I have not done a darn thing to see what I'm going to do or do any setup. Done. Got a few things. I remember looking at this at the end of one other video, but I don't remember what I saw. Trees are still being cut near the airdrome. As many logs as possible should be hauled to the local sawmill. Get ready, bring your friends. It's a long road ahead. I do remember that they were almost exclusively logging jobs. I think there was one that wasn't. Oversized cargo, concrete slabs. Oh yeah, the cargo-opalypse jobs. Yeah, more logging. And the locked cargo-opalypse till you do the first one. Well, let's just run them down in order here. Deliver to the sawmill in White Valley. 2 medium log and 2 long log. All right. Well, let's get this thing down to the garage, shall we? Ooh, that looks like an interesting ride up over the top over there. On this side is just a nice serene valley. Of course, no, that's not the garage, I don't think. Garage is more right there. I should probably turn on my controller. Huh. More to show you, I haven't done a darn thing but turn the game on. I don't remember what this place gives you down here. I remember it's a bitch to get to. I mean, unless you take a Kras Chabors and go over the top. Let's go see what we can load out here. There's part of the road. Main road in and out is right there in front of us, but it looks fine here, but it gets nasty up further ahead. Wow, what's happening? I made the turn. Drilling spare parts. That's it. Nothing but drilling spare parts. Okay. So, probably won't need to come down here for any reason. I misjudged my backing blind. There we go. Now let's have a little fun. There is a road there, you can see, but what's the fun in roads? We'll go get some equipment to do that first job with. Wow, that nosed in hard. This thing is not short by any means. Oh, can we go over the top of this? Sure we can. Oh, we found the road. road goes down through that mud hole. I've been on this road several times. There used to be an upgrade right in this area. Right in there, where it's wet. Might have to back up to avoid flipping, but maybe not. And there's the garage. I don't think there's an opening in the wall to go in through the back. Now we'll fix this up and we'll get a, one of the hated long log trailers. Just because it can haul two logs. I have not fixed up the gooseneck trailers to work any better than they did before. So we'll have to do a pull behind, unfortunately. Let's turn this around so I don't have to mess with backing up a pull behind. And no, I did not take the time. Well, this is the live server, but what I started to say is I've not taken the time to turn on the dev tools menu on white silence or to upgrade any of the trailers. I just did not do it. I was too busy working or passing out because I worked. I fell asleep with my dinner in the microwave or oven. Woke up sometime later and ate my cheeseburger that I brought home from work. See, as I remember, the long log was way down at the bottom. And then we need something to pull the medium log. So even something like that will only pull one unit of long logs. I go past it or not to it yet. Or is it in a completely different spot on the live server? I'm up too far. I would so much rather just pull freight. There's the GGMS long log pull behind. Oh, the hated long log pull behind. But it will take two units of log at the same time, so, and the job requires two long, two medium. The two medium is easier to do. Where do I get long logs? Ah, that's not bad. That's not bad at all. Out here, take the cutover. It's across from the fuel station. worry about how we're getting the medium logs there when we need to get them there. Though I'd like to do the crossover only once. I don't think it's this one. Let's take a look. No, that goes across that stupid little bridge, and it's a longer road. I would know it by sight, but I haven't played this in a long time. This map. That goes down to that other plant we were at. I do remember if you don't cut this corner, you have a hard time with the mud there. Besides the pole being right on the corner. Maybe, I guess we'll load the long logs and then see what we're gonna do for short logs. Is it there or over there? That's freight. Shouldn't matter if I'm straight with the trailer when the truck doesn't have any log carrying capacity, but we ended up straight anyways. Are two long logs, which makes it more unstable having the weight of two on there instead of one, but shit happens, don't it? Let's get this around the corner. So we got to figure out where we're getting mediums. Can we get mediums here? I didn't think to check before I pulled away. Let's go to the garage, which is back down over here. Yeah, there it is. Storage or store? You know, there's a new Western Star. I've never touched it. I didn't even know I had it until it updated today. No. Is this it? No, that's the 49X. Which would probably work fine too, but I'm looking for this, the Spartan. Let's see what this is like. Again, I've never even seen this except that I know it updated today. So I don't know how it drives. or anything. I think my mouse is starting to double click when I don't intend it to. But the standard leaves the SN drooping. Stock has the nicest look to it, but we'll try the raised and see. Sometimes with the stock suspension, you can't get the biggest wheels. Looks like 52 are the biggest. And those should be dualies on the rear. Yeah. Studded mud dualies. One's underneath on one side, this is underneath on the other, and this is most likely on the back. Oh, it's a second one up front. Okay. They're only good for one tire apiece, one wheel apiece. That looks like it was meant to be there. Let's see, I could do a medium log carrier on the front. And then pull a medium log carrier, and that's my two. So I could do three if I wanted to set it up that way, but I don't need to. Well, that's about it, I guess. Because anything else would kick off the log carrier, I think. Articulated towing platform? Oh, that's what it is. Tatra sideboard, PC320 heavy. There's no RU to worry about trying, so there we are. Probably don't have any points worth of shit, but... Oh, what it has, let's see. Four and 40. And there's nothing else like a roof rack on here, so. Why doesn't it show us the front? That kicks off the horns. There we go. Oh, geez. That's fine. Move on. that utility mount? That's got a few points. It clips through the logging thing. I don't know if that'll matter. I bet it will. Exhaust, wedge cap, muzzle, outrolled, stock, both wedge cap. And I'll probably take off that utility mount. It's going to interfere with putting logs on it, and I won't know that until I get all the way over there. There we are. There's those 600. Let's see what this thing's like. I've got a Western Star. I've got the same thing, a Western Star 4964. From a different mod developer. I think the four-axle trailer with the stake sides probably be the best thing to put. Yeah. That's got 1,000 points on it, too. There we are. Now, can we pick up mediums at the same place? It's showing. Yeah. Medium and long. Cool. Cool beans, Mario. Don't ask who Mario is. I think of weird shit like that just off the top of my head. Decent turning radius. Moves right out. Whoa. Quick to turn, slow to come back. Gonna be fighting with that all the way, but shit happens. Look, it stood up again. What is this sitting and spinning shit? All-wheel drive is on. Diff lock is always engaged. It's got good wheels on it. This will have to be lined up straight to load the trailer. That's done. Let's take a look at what we got. Neato. All right, let's take a look at where we're going with it all. White Valley, over in that corner. All right. So we can turn back around and go around. I have no clue what the center of gravity is like or anything like that on this truck. So while I might ordinarily pull this truck with the Kraz Chavors over there, I kind of want to keep a closer eye on it. So I can maybe not tip it over. I can go back out to the asphalt road or stay in the mud. Thinking about staying in the mud, so maybe I'm not bouncing off of rocks, you know, getting it up to full speed and then slam into a rock. And dump the log. I wonder what high range is like on this. Ah, it's nicer. It's easier to steer when it's going a steady speed instead of up and down, you know, and it's not slogging along in first gear all the time. But now I'm gonna need first. Gotta go around this island and out this way. Whee! And now we're right back to the garage. So if you want to have a better driving experience with this mod, stick it in high. So many of them are like that anymore. Seems to be like the fad. To just run them in high instead of letting it shift up and down, because shifting up and down is such a slow process, and it doesn't have to be. It's all in your gear designation. Whoa. Former rock obstruction. See, I wasn't doing all this damage until I got on the asphalt road. We should be getting the gateway pretty quick, or at least the turn for it. I think staying to the right here gets us to the gateway. Yep, there it is. Woo, come on. Sliding on the corner. Now the sign is still laying in the snow, so. That's where we'll stop with this one. We'll go back and get the crashed pores. And I'd like to say get to the gateway much faster, but not with what I'm pulling. Maybe that thing's not full-time diff lock, which would explain why I was doing the sit and spin so much. This one I'll probably go up the road to assist in not tipping over the trailer. Any other trailer in the game might have to make two separate trips. No, and I just remembered about keeping the dolly locked. But on the road here, it shouldn't matter. We're not making such drastic turns. I could throw this thing in high and just cruise along, but it might get going too fast. Give it a try. Should just roll right along, except for having to steer it. That was a guardrail. That's one thing with this very long truck. You gotta play with the guardrails all the time. Oh, by the way, this is Tuesday for me. My day off. In between Monday and Wednesday. I work Monday, I work Wednesday. And it's 11:45. I just published a white silence video about, I don't know, an hour ago. Then I fired up the game and did some other stuff while the downloads were finishing. The mod updates, I had four of them that needed to update the last time I was playing. A couple days ago. So I knew this time I would just start up the game and then do some other shit while I was waiting. Uh-oh. Was that a signpost? Looks like I hit it, but it didn't tip over. It just bugged out. But if the truck suddenly goes launching to the moon, I'll know that there's a sign stuck under it. Alright, let's see if we can finagle one passage. That might be difficult with such a small travel zone. And simply putting them side by side won't matter. It'll only take the truck that you initiated travel from. So I gotta put a rope between them. And they both have to be in the travel zone at the same time. So, how do I connect them with a rope? Is that gonna do it? Let's try. White Valley. Wow. Where did the time go? We're already 40 minutes in. Well, it looks like they both came over. Yippee! We'll just stay in this one for now and figure out where we gotta go. We have to... It doesn't say in White Valley, but I suppose that's because we are in White Valley. Could have gotten long logs over here, but sawmill, that's where we're going, and then we can make wooden planks. Isn't that special? We can make wooden planks that we have no use for. Okay, around here, across the bridge, follow the road past the factory and trailer store. Oh, looks like here we gotta go this way. Yeah, okay. So, you guys can help me remember to turn left by the factory trailer store. Otherwise, it's just following the road. Following the road that goes to the right. That says tunnel. Whoops, there's that darn oversteer. Okay, got it on the straight and narrow, so dang that steering. Factory. Now the diff lock is shaded out, so it's got to be all time. The steering on this thing is like going too far and then having to catch it and bring it back. Yep. That little windy road go in there? No, it just brings us back to this road. That was probably the bypass before we built the bridge. this could be a lot more useful truck with a few minor adjustments. I'd say traction, gearing, and steering. That's where the other end of that little road comes in. I've been on the Michigan region more recently when I was doing my new beginning playthrough that got cut short thanks to Saber. I haven't been on Alaska in probably the better part of a year. Let's try running up this hill at a better angle, and then back down at a better angle, except it wouldn't do it because of the bush. One stinking little bush sitting there keeps the truck from turning left. Should say sawmill. Lumber mill. So this will complete the two medium logs. That would be an obstruction, except I'm using the Trees Dawn mod. Come on, quit going too far. It's trying to get it lined up straight with each other, and it keeps going too far one way or the other. All right, two medium logs. Bada bing, bada boom, and we're on to the next part. Get the Kraz Chabors down here. There she is. Nice smooth corner. only thing I have to worry about on this one is not tipping over the trailer. Come on! Ah, you motherfucker. What did I just say? And there's one on the ground. Why couldn't I keep all four of them in there? Son of a bitch. Now I don't have a second load. What did I say? Don't tip it over. I can repack one, but not the second without the other log. And this type of crane won't pick it up. Ah, fuck me. I hate this trailer. I really, really do. But when it works, you can deliver two loads of long logs at the same time. But because it's overloaded, it's gotta go this way. Once it starts going over, it doesn't come back. Need to make the springs stronger, I think. They're already pretty high. I have them like 0.55, and normally they'd be 0.3. The damping is already higher than it would be. Would be ordinarily. I cut the twist motor down to half, meaning it shouldn't lay over as far, but it still does. Oh my God. It off that little hump. Even something that slight could tip it over. Now, I was just noticing that we could get long logs here. So here, like this, and then there's a different road, but it's further back, it's not really accessible. Well, when I get here, just keep going this way. So we're not done yet. We would be done. Oh, there's no way out there. Ain't that a bummer? Make a way out. But of course, now this very first waypoint I placed is gonna bite me in the ass. Anybody want to take bets on how many times this load of long logs breaks the bands? Not necessarily dumps on the ground, but breaks the bands. I'm thinking twice. All that work to get two of them over here at the same time. I mean, there's other trailers I could use, except that I wanted to pull two of them. There's other trailers that wouldn't be such a pain in the ass. Oh yeah, this is a log dumper here. Maybe we can go around the other side. No, not the loading platform, the trailer, dang it. Should I put two on just to just in case? That would just ensure that it tips over. And I'm not done locking the dolly. Trying not to back up very much because that will tip over the trailer. I gotta see if I can fix up the gooseneck models of this trailer. That doesn't look too bad from this side. meant to do that. This is where I said we would dump it over. That and the place ahead, right in front of me. I think this is just a mud hole. It's getting too dark now. I want to be able to read the terrain better. That tree is meant to not allow you to do what I did. Yeah, I knew I probably wouldn't clear, but I didn't want to take a chance on backing the trailer over that tree. Everybody lost, unless you said zero times, as far as dumping the logs. All right, a lot easier with only one on it, one log loaded, instead of two doubles the weight. I could maybe lessen the weight of the logs, but, you know, screw it. Ta-da! Airdrome logging done. And we're at an hour 4.5, so thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.